It's rare to see producers become as visible as the rappers they make beats for, but in recent years some have been able to brand themselves to the point of being stars in their own right. Metro Boomin is the perfect example. With the advent of producer tags for mostly southern beat makers, guys like Metro, Zaytoven and Mike Almeida don't leave any room for guesswork. Their signatures are unavoidable at the start of nearly every song they create. That's helped bring awareness to the fact that producers work just as hard, if not harder, than the rappers whose hits they help make. That should seem obvious, but being behind the boards means being behind the faces of the songs too, even if some producers are helping rappers with their hooks as well. This year, XXL takes a look at some of the best producers of the year, people who toiled behind the scenes to make the beats your favorite rappers spit over. They aren't all as self-branded as the guys mentioned above, though some, like Junona Beat, DJ Fresh and Wheezy also use their own subtle signatures, but they all have emerged as being instrumental to the success of the songs they made. Here 30 of the best hip-hop producers of 2016. In 2012-13, Mike Will made it was the game's go-to producer, but when the tide shifted to favor DJ Mustard instead, Mike kept working. Now he's back on top thanks to Ray Shrimmer's No. 1 hit single, Black Beatles, Beyoncé's, Formation, Thuggers, F Cancer, and Titty Boy's MFN Right. The list goes on as the Atlanta producer continues to fine-tune his sound. Now can we get Ransom 2, OVO's secret weapon, 1985 had his name ringing with Drake's Hotline Bling last year, and he didn't waste any time capitalizing on the attention. He helped produce the biggest song of Drake's career so far, One Dance, which was also one of the biggest tracks this year, as well as a couple other joints off Views. He steered the direction for Division's debut album September 5th too, and now he's up for a Grammy next year. This man is a beast. He used to be part of the core in-house production team for Wiz Big Germ, ID Labs, Johnny Giuliano, but he's since gone on to work with everyone from Kendrick to HOV. This year he ran the gamut again, landing beats on Travis Scott's Birds in the Trap, Sing McKnight, Goosebumps, Kendrick's Untitled Unmastered, Untitled O2, and DRAM's Big Baby DRAM, In a Minute, In-House, to name a few, as well as completely producing one of the hardest tapes of the year, Payroll Giovanni's Big Boss and Volume 1, look out for Cardo's solo album Lost in a World coming in 2017, who else in hip-hop would release one of the best albums of the year? And then continue to tweak it once it went up for sale? At first it seemed like a terrible rollout, in retrospect, it was just a mad genius refusing to finish his work. Zaytoven produced for everybody this year, Gucci Mane, Lil Uzi Vert, Young Dolph, Future and Lil Durk. Zaytoven was as much a part of Guwap's return as Mr. Zone 6 himself, helping to improve his longevity and show the world his chemistry with Gucci hasn't gone anywhere. The leader of Atlanta's new school of producers had another monster year, fueled by 21 Savage's Savage Mode, a project Metro rightfully gets artist credit on. 2016 solidified his status as the most instantly recognizable producer in the game, serving as a testament to the power of personal branding. Now wait until his track with Kodak drops. Thugger fans know all about Wheezy. He was the mastermind behind the production on Barter 6 and he doubled down this year, producing mutant beats for Thug Like Gangster Shit, King Troop, and Swizz Beatz, but his most slept-on contributions of the year are on the wrongly ignored Bankroll Mafia album. YG's Still Brazy is one of the best produced albums of the year, and it's largely thanks to DJ Swish, the guy behind centerpieces like Don't Come to LA, Who Shot Me, Gimme Got Shot, and Fuck Donald Trump. Probably helps that he got an assist or two from production genius Terrace Martin on the album as well. Everybody knew before even hearing the new Tribe Called Quest album that at the very least, the beats would be banging. Turns out the whole project was fire, but Tip made the old sound new and breathed life into a group that rap fans had all but given up hope on. Not only did Frank Dukes have his hands on everything released this year, but he also innovated the way producers can access sampling by playing original material and offering it up for other beat makers to purchase. Fuse, The Life of Pablo, Stoney, Jeffery and Starboy are just some of the LPs Frank lent his magic to this year. The legendary Mike Dean has been in the game for nearly 25 years now, and he's still amongst the cream of the crop when it comes to production. But his experience behind the boards has also gifted him with a golden ear, allowing him to become a mixing and mastering guru as well. He even plays live guitar in keys, dude is a pure virtuoso. The smartest thing Drake, or was it 40, has done in the past couple years is adding this guy to his production arsenal. Vinyls produced, You With Me, Off Views, 4 PM in Calabasas, and Fake Love, from the forthcoming More Life project, which you can expect him to be all over. Kamaya broke out last year with How Does It Feel, produced by CT Beats, and she went back to the Oakland producer for four more cuts on one of the best projects of the year, A Good Night in the Ghetto. His beats are so dope, even YG had to cop one for Why You Always Hating. Kodak Black's got a sound all his own, but AA helps him craft it. Songs like Everything 1K, Bibbin in This Bitch, and Slade were all done by the Florida producer, who also made his way on NBA YoungBoy's 38 Baby mixtape. They've got an entire project on the way. But AA is so dependable, he brought